While what you are looking at might initially look like a mining explosion, it is instead a volcanic eruption from Indonesia's Ibu volcano. Located on the island of Halmahera, Ibu frequently produces these types of explosions which are known as volcanian eruptions. These often generate pyroclastic flows and sometimes occur alongside the ejection of bombs of lava. Ibu is one of Earth's 49 volcanoes which are actively erupting as of the week of January 7, 2024. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the same week which an Alaskan volcano's eruption was declared as over, a new volcanic eruption may have occurred elsewhere in the United States at a submarine volcano. Elsewhere in the Philippines, ground deformation was detected on the northern section of the Taal volcano's central island, along with a one-year high in sulfur dioxide emissions. And, in what is this week's top story, the eruption of Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano is becoming increasingly intense and dangerous. This eruption, which began on December 23rd of 2023, initially involved only minor ash emissions from a 160-meter-long vent just northwest of the Laki-Laki Cone's summit area. However, this fissure was insufficient to relieve all of the pressure from the body of shallow magma, resulting in a second fissure opening on the Laki-Laki Cone's southeastern flank on December 31st. This fissure resulted in heavier ash emissions, causing a centimeter of ash to fall on the village of Boru. Yet, the eruption intensity still continued to progressively increase, and as a result, not only was the Laki-Laki Cone's alert level raised from yellow to orange, but its exclusion zone was expanded. Additionally, some people at distances as much as 8 kilometers away evacuated, totaling approximately 2,500 people. This increasing eruption intensity still did not appear to release all of the pressure building at the volcano, creating the potential for 3 scenarios to play out. It appears that scenario 2 has so far occurred as the 160-meter-long fissure expanded by another 100 meters on January 5th. On the same day, an orange glow began emanating from the cone's summit as fragments of shallow magma were ejected beyond the crater walls. It now appears to be a matter of time before a true lava flow begins. In addition to the threat of lava flows, pyroclastic flows, and ash, I am quite concerned by the truly heavy levels of volcanic gas this eruption is emitting. As, on January 5th, locals who were 7 kilometers northwest of the eruption began complaining about a nasty sulfur smell and feeling very nauseous. While nausea is a potential symptom of overexposure to each of 3 deadly volcanic gases, I suspect that hydrogen sulfide is the culprit here. If you are feeling nauseous due to volcanic gases, evacuate immediately as you are encountering a dangerous level of this gas. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, sulfur dioxide emissions have increased to unusually high levels at the Taal volcano, where since December 21st they have nearly doubled. On January 4th, 12,685 tons of sulfur dioxide gas was released, and this is actually higher than the erupting Lewotobi volcano in Indonesia is releasing. The presence of sulfur dioxide gas indicates that magma is at fairly shallow depths, which in this case either is increasing in volume, getting shallower, or a combination of both. Almost all of Taal's phreatomagmatic explosions from its central crater lake since February of 2020 have occurred on days when more than 10,000 tons of this magmatic gas have been released. Thus, an eruption, potentially of small to medium size, is becoming increasingly likely at Taal. However, there is also a possibility that such a new eruption could originate on the northern section of Taal Island, as uplift has been centered and ongoing there since July 12th of 2023. And, in the depths of the northern Mariana Islands, the Ahyi Seamount volcano appears to have erupted again either on December 31st or January 1st. Although the eruption was not directly witnessed, satellite imagery showed a discolored patch of water which had drifted a few miles west of the volcano. While this was likely generated by an eruption, it is also possible that a short burst of fumarolic gases created this light blue patch of water instead of an eruption. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing varying degrees of unrest which are not currently erupting as of January 6th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Oliver Hoppe, for supporting this channel.